Welcome back. It is Drex from down the other end of the hole from CFOX, hanging out here at CKNW, covering for Mike Eckford for the rest of the week. He's back on Monday with fantastic hair, and that's all you need to know about that. According to our next guest, snowboarders are about the only people who can wear goofy-looking pants and still look cool. But what about denim on the hill? A lot of young people love wearing jeans when they snowboard, especially if there's no clouds in the sky, it's nice and sunny, and the powder is fresh. Jason Mason loves snowboarding in jeans, so one problem kind of plagued him. They'd get wet and he'd feel cold. So he spoke to us about how he overcame that problem. He started a small business in Whistler and continues to rip down the mountain in jeans.
Waterproof jeans, you're crazy.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
How did you come up with this invention?
Well, I just really love snowboarding in jeans, and, you know, it's 2013, well, it's almost 2014, but I just really love snowboarding in jeans, and, you know, I think we're far enough along that I figured it was out there, and
well, you know what, it's such a tight market. It's such a tight market for ski apparel, right? So, you these big, huge brand names have the market cornered with the snowboard pants. And let's be honest, snowboard pants are kind of enormous and big and bulky, and you got to change out of them. So you've just said, you know what? And a lot of guys do, depending on how the weather is in the sky. If it's nice blue sky, generally you will find a ton of guys snowboarding in jeans. So you've just gone, hey, hang on, I'll take the technology from this and the technology from my Levi's and join them together.
Exactly. Yeah. I just wanted to keep the real street style aesthetic on the mountain. Like, I didn't want no half step in. I didn't want a snowboard pant with a denim like material. I wanted real jeans that worked in the snow.
So when you came up with this idea, what was the first thing you did? Did you go and try and find a waterproof type of denim?
Well, first I started off with criteria, everything I thought the pants needed to be. And that's, so I started off with a list, and I sort of went down the list and just checked each, like, can I do this? Can I do this? Can I make this possible? And if I couldn't do that, then I wasn't going to do this at all, because it wouldn't be worth it, right? I wouldn't be adding anything new. And so luckily, it was just part of the criteria. And yeah, and then I just started looking around, like, for different sorts of technologies. And it was like a small lab in Arkansas or something that actually realized the technology. And then it was passed along to me. And then we took it and we altered it again to reflect the materials and the conditions that we were going to be using them in. Because I use, it's traditional authentic denim, and they have stretch in them. So I use cotton, poly, and spandex. And, you know, and I wanted them to last all day on the mountain. So, you know, we changed it up a bit, and, you know, I think I'll be honest, it worked way better than I thought it was going to be. Like, it was,
your fluke worked.
It was cool, man. Pardon?
So your fluke worked.
Yeah. Well, no, I wouldn't say it was a fluke. I mean, it was, everything was calculated, and the idea was, you know, executed on in a way that I thought it should have been. And it was just nice to see it work. You know, it was just nice to be like, yeah, I thought this, and you know, that and that and that, and then when you put it into play, it's like, God dang, it all worked.
So what's your background? Do you have a background in fashion design or technology or anything? What's your background, man?
Well, my background is just, I come from snowboarding and skateboarding. I started skateboarding when I was 11, and then I started snowboarding, you know, that season sort of thing. And so I've been snowboarding since I was 11, skateboarding since I was 11, and, you know, I didn't just own a skateboard, and I didn't just own a snowboard. Like, I am a skateboarder, and I am a snowboarder. Like, it's, you know, I grew up, I live it, it's been my culture my whole life,
yeah.
And you know, and I spent some time in Whistler, you know, snowboarding, and, you know, I was fortunate enough there to have some pretty cool sponsors, and then I went to Australia for a year, and I was skating there, and I had some pretty cool sponsors there, and then the last 10 years I've been working in film and television and video production, shooting and editing. And in terms of like fashion, I've skateboarding fashion has always been on the forefront of the rest of the, like, skateboarders always seem to do it first and then everyone else sort of catches on later.
Yeah, it's true.
And you know, being so deep into skateboarding, you know, I always knew, you know, you just know, you know, what works and what doesn't, what's cool and what's not. And And so, yeah, I just wanted my stuff to reflect that. And, you know, I spend a lot of time at the thrift stores, too, because I like, I always like going there and seeing, because you get so many eclectic different brands and, you know, clothes from all over the world. And it was always, I always liked looking at, you know, what people tried with this sort of denim and what they tried with that sort of denim and, you know, what worked here and what, you know, what I thought worked and what I thought didn't work. And, you know, it was just a Saturday for me, and I didn't really realize that all that time I was spending, like, I mean, thrift stores my whole life. I just like looking at clothes. I like looking at how things are put together and made. And so, yeah, when I made the first prototypes myself with a sewing machine I found in the garbage room of my building. And cause my mom taught me how to sew when I was a kid, and I took a sewing class in the seventh grade.
Yeah,
and I found this machine and it had thread in it, and I was like, "All right, let's do it."
So how long ago did you make that first pair of prototypes?
Would have been over the summer of 2012.
Yeah,
and then I got I sent off my rickety prototypes to my team in China, and they sent me back. The real deal, and I started off last season wearing my own pants for the first time, and it was cool, man. Like,
are they now in full production? What's the story? Can I go buy a pair if I want?
Yeah, please. I hope you do. I hope everyone listening goes and buys a pair.
I would probably have to start snowboarding first. I think I'm the only Australian that lives in Canada that hasn't snowboarded yet.
Oh, come on, mate. Get up there. I rode Mount Buller, and I rode Mount...
So you've gone in less than a year from making a pair of rickety prototypes on a sewing machine that you found in the basement of the building you live in to being in full production of this product.
Yeah, and we're in two stores in Whistler, Evolution Shop in Whistler and the Skate Cave in Whistler,
yeah.
And we're in Stuntwood in Squamish, and SC Sport. I think yeah, there's two shops on the island. I'm not really sure how much they're selling out, though.
So these pants, what do they retail for?
And online. It's $223, and then plus tax, it's about $249.76.
What's the brand name?
The brand name is Mason Industries. We make water repellent, abrasion resistant, 100% breathable, fully lined stretch denim for action sports.
Dude, he knows his tagline. What's your website? Give me that.
MasonIndustries.ca, and yeah, you can click on there. You can see videos of one of my pros, Jeff Murhead's, talking about, you know, the product, and there's videos of him riding, and there's videos of the pants, like, water being poured on them,
yeah.
And it's cool. I mean, my biggest challenge right now is just letting people know that, you know, this is real, this exists.
Yeah,
like, you don't have to wear what's being given to you, because what a lot of people don't realize is, you know, the snowboard fashion isn't really... It's not really the snowboarders and the designers putting it out. It's accountants that design, that make the clothes.
Yeah,
the accountants say, well, that sold last year. Let's replicate it and do it this year, except this time we're going to add another zipper.
Do you find that now that you're a guy that's producing something for snowboarding, are you in turn sponsoring other snowboarders with your products?
Yeah, I sponsor Jeff Murhead and Wes Makepeace. And I have I sponsor a girl in Michigan, well, Quebec, and she rides in Michigan. Claudia Hutchinson, and I'm picking up a new guy in Michigan too. He rides at Treetop Resort, and we're going to be picking him up, Derek, and he's going to be riding for us and repping for us. And yeah, I've seen videos of him, and he's a pretty rad dude, and we're pretty excited. And I mean, just, you know, we were up the other day testing out the new jackets, because I have jackets coming out now too.
Yeah.
Jeff got dressed in the parking lot, and I was kind of putting my boots on. I look up, and he's, you know, it's the first time I get to see someone wearing the pants and jacket together, you know, and man, did he look cool. Like,
so is the jacket made out of the same material as the pants?
Yeah, I got two jackets right now. I got a denim jacket, which is called the Drifter, and yeah. You know, cause it's, I like hitchhiking, and I like, you know, that transient sort of lifestyle. You know, because that's a lot of skateboarding, snowboarding, just traveling.
Jason, you know, you've essentially made a waterproof Canadian tuxedo.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I know. Yeah, the Canadian tuxedo, exactly.
Oh, there you go. That is Jason, who joined us on the phone to talk about his amazing jeans that are waterproof, and you can look up his stuff too. We'll put a link up on the CKNW Facebook page. We'll be right back to tell you what we've got coming up tomorrow night's show here at CKNW.